Hi, I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and this is my review of the Avada theme. I think you can sum up the Avada theme in one word, and that is options. This theme is filled with tons of different options and settings that will help you get the look of the website that you want. It's also kind of the downside of this theme is that there are so many options and settings. But let's go ahead and take a look.
So this is a web page that I made with the Avada theme. I used some images here, like this image here is a picture that I took, but I also used some images that I got from Unsplash. And I've got actually a whole resource of free image sites that you can use on your website. So if you go to realwebsitehints.com/free images, you'll find a listing of websites that have free images that you can use for your web projects. And actually, you'll find a link to everything that I talk about in this video, including the Avada theme, right below this video or at realwebsitehints.com/Avada. What I really found that I liked about the Avada theme was that it just has tons and tons and tons of settings, which makes it really easy to sort of customize the look and feel of your site so that it's really unique for you. And the great thing about that is you can do all of that without using any code. And a little later on, I'll show you exactly how the settings work and what the back end of the website is like. But first, let's go ahead and check out this page that I made. So we can see here, we've got this clear header bar with our menu in it. And as we scroll down, it turns white and changes to this. And then I've got this section here, which is actually a slider section. And the slider section just has enough features in it to make it useful without, you know, leaving out too many features and without, you know, having too many features that's complex. It does come bundled with some other slider plugins, which I didn't get a chance to try, but I found that the standard slider seems to work pretty well and do a lot of the things that, you know, you just basically need to do. As you can see, the slider here actually has text in it, and this text is not part of the image. This text is actually HTML coded into the slider, and that's pretty cool. And one of the things that I kind of liked about it was the fact that you could use this parallax effect and have that slide up over it. So you can see here, we get a lot of, you know, layout options. We've got background options and these button options here. And what's cool is that these buttons you can control the look of. So you can design, you know, several different kinds of buttons, or many actually different kinds of buttons, using the settings in the theme. So this gives you a lot of options for buttons. And this is actually an icon, and there's a bunch of icons that are included as part of the theme. So you can see just, you know, some really, you know, great, simple, crisp looks. I don't really consider myself a designer. I'm sort of more of like a design hacker. So I look at, you know, I get inspiration from other websites. And I, in this case, I got a lot of inspiration from some of the demos. And I'm going to show you some of the demos for this theme. And then just, you know, was able to put them together. And I was really impressed by the fact that I could actually put together this website and put together just about anything you'll see in the demos later on without having to know any code. And I think that that speaks a lot about this theme and their marketing, and the fact that it says that you can make these web pages without any code, and you really can. Some other themes that I've come across, it says, you know, that it helps you make websites. Might not say that you can use code or not, but you sort of get that implication that you can. And you really can't, because you really have to know some CSS and some HTML in order to be able to make the sites look the way they do in their demos. But with this, I found that I think just about everything in their demos you can actually do without knowing any code, just using the settings that are included in the theme. All these icons are included in the theme, and you've got various different ways which you can use them, and various different modules, or I think they call them elements, that you can use them with. So I think it's, you know, a very clean looking, nice website. And if you want to see how I put together this website, I'm going to put a free demo on YouTube that'll show you exactly how I made this page. Check out some of the demos. I was really impressed with the demos. These are professionally designed demos by professional designers, so I think there's no doubt that they're going to look good. But, you know, here you can see we've got that clear menu section here, and there's a lot of different menu options. I'll show you some more. But you can see this one here scrolls away. It doesn't stay with it. And we've got just this really nice looking site. We've got this little carrot icon here, and that's not part of the theme, I don't think, but it's an image that you can put in and you can sort of design your own. I didn't get a chance to play with that, but I'm 90% sure that I know exactly how they did it, and it's just using their image module and having it set to the top of this module. So that's pretty cool. I've always wanted to be able to do that in a theme, and this theme will allow you to do that. Get these sign-up boxes that the theme includes, these cool little icons with the animations in them. Let's check out another one. So this is a shop icon. So they say that their theme is fully integrated with WooCommerce. I didn't get a chance to test that myself, but I believe that WooCommerce works with a lot of different themes. One thing I did want to know is how they do this, and I didn't get a chance in my demo to figure out how they do that, but I think that's kind of a cool, these little slide-up things. And then this is another section that I really like and have always wanted to be able to do in a theme without having to know any code, and where each one of these is actually a different section, and then it's got the text over it, and the text is HTML text, and getting these full-width backgrounds. And I think that's a really great thing to be able to do, whether you use different just solid color backgrounds or your own sort of graphic background that you create, or images like this. It's a really nice way to add some design elements to your site easily, and this theme allows you to do that and allows you to have it full width and have these images just, you know, touch each other just like that. And this theme is fully responsive, so as you can see, as we drag it across here, it's going to scale and work on, you know, like a smartphone, so this is sort of like a smartphone size. And that's really important for your website to have it be compatible and be found in Google, because Google has mandated that all websites need to be mobile friendly, and so this theme is by default mobile friendly. And it does give you additional controls for mobile if you want a section to appear or not appear on mobile. You've got those options in the settings. As I said before, there's just lots and lots of settings with this theme. Here we go, here's another example. We just have a white menu bar heading, and this one here stays with the page. So, you know, some great looks. Just really, you know, simple design elements that can be added. And here's an example of the full width sections that are butted up right together against each other with different colors to sort of give you that really nice, easy way of adding some good design to your website. Another example here, we've got this menu up here, and you can see it's semi-transparent, which is another nice feature. So as I said, there's lots of different ways you can make the menu look and make it really fit your site. And I think that, you know, the menu design is one of the main differentiations between different themes, and being able to change the settings on the menu in so many different ways really helps you make the website look like it's your own. And I really like this section here. I didn't get a chance to figure out how they did it, but I think they just did a different image background. And then as you swipe up, it changes the image. So I thought that was really cool. Here we go. Here's another example of a different menu. We've got this side menu here, and you can see the colors are all changed. And that's one of the great things about this theme, is that you can change all of the colors, and you can change the global settings for the colors on the text. So the colors really match your brand. A really nice feature. And again, all of these things that you're seeing here, they can all be done just by adjusting the settings within the theme. So very nice. Okay, so here's a different heading example. You can see it's added this extra bar up here, and that's one of the options that you have in the header sections for this theme. And then as you scroll down, it scrolls down to just sort of this more minimized menu. We also have this section here, which is imagine they use the slider like I did, and you can actually have a button in it. And it's parallax, which is just kind of, you know, a neat trick that you've got a button with parallax attached to it. So you've got this text in here and then a button. I just really like that. And I really like the fact that all of these demos they actually did with their theme and the settings designed to their theme. They didn't resort to, you know, some trickery by using CSS to make different things happen. I mean, there might be a few instances where they have used CSS or their own HTML code, but from what I could figure out and from looking at these demo examples, they didn't really do that. It's pretty much all just settings built right into their theme. So it's very nice. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at the back end of this theme and how you sort of design the pages and what that looks like. So let's first look at the options. So if you click up here and go to Avada and then you click on Theme Options, you can see here that we've got just a ton of options. All of these are styling options and various different options to get the look and feel of your web page. And you can see there's just a ton of options. And that's kind of one of the great things about this theme, is that you really have an option for just about everything. And they're really well thought out to help you design a unique look to your site. But at the same time, there are just a ton of options, and it can be a little bit overwhelming to go through them. One of the other nice features that I liked that they added was a backup for the settings, because once you get in there and you start adjusting all of your settings, and for my demo and my test of it, I really went in and I adjusted quite a few of the settings. It's nice to know that you can back it up and save that, so that if you make a mistake and change something by accident, you can resort to your backup of the settings. It does come with several predefined color schemes, which you can play with, but I wound up just picking my own colors and going through all of the settings and adjusting that. And then let's look at one of the pages, and we can see how the page builder works. So click on Pages here. We'll look at the home page. And so you turn on the Fusion Builder, and that's the builder that comes as part of the theme. And then we've got these different sections and section widths that we can add here. And you add them just by dragging and then dropping them into place. And then you can add, you know, various different sections like this. And what's great about it is that if you, you know, make a mistake like this and you've got sections that aren't exactly compatible, you can just hit the minus button until it fits. So you can use the minus or plus to sort of change the size of these different sections, which is really nice. And then we have these builder elements, and we've got a bunch of different builder elements to give different looks and different feels to each of your sections. We've got text block here, which is probably going to be one of the most common ones used, title, separator, and then a bunch of different other options, which are really useful for designing a page without knowing any code. One of the things I didn't like about the way that this theme works is that when you get down here to the bottom, on the Divi theme, for example, which is a very similar type of page builder, you just click into each section and then it gives you all of the options for their different, I think they call them modules here, they're called elements, and you can just sort of click away and go and add the different sections. Whereas here, you've got to scroll up to the top, grab the element that you want, and then just drag it down to the bottom of the page. That's a little bit more time-consuming for doing a design than like the Divi theme, for example. But I do think that this theme gives you a lot more options for adjusting the look. Because, you know, within each one of these containers, we've got, you know, all of these different options, all of these different options, all of these different options. And then within each element, also you've got, you know, more options and additional options. And then within each page, at the bottom here, we've got all of these different options for each page, too. So as you can see, it is a lot of options, which is really great because you can make the design that you want and do it all without knowing code, but it can definitely be a little bit overwhelming. And I'm actually going to work on an online course that will show you exactly how to set up your website and to save you a ton of time by helping you set up all of the settings that you need to give that unique look to your website right from the start, so that you don't have to go through and figure out where all the settings are and which ones you should adjust first and second. Because I already learned a lot about how to use this theme by doing this demo, and now I know exactly sort of the steps to take and the process to make, so I can save you a lot of time with my online course. So that's a look and my review of the Avada theme. I think it's a great theme. It's really good for designers or design hackers like me, who aren't maybe professional designers, but want to look at some examples, like the examples that they've provided, these, you know, sort of professionally done examples. Oh, this is one more example I didn't show you guys here. But here we've got this like giant splash image here with text above it, and then you scroll down, and then your menu appears. I thought that was another really cool feature that they added. But yeah, you can look at all these different design elements that they've done with all of their demos and sort of pick and choose and decide which things you like. And then you can actually do it with this theme. And I think that's really impressive. Some of the problems that I had with this theme was on install. Apparently a common problem that they have is that you get an error message because the file size of the actual theme, I guess, is too large. And so it might not be able to unzip on your server. So you might have to actually extract the files for the theme on your computer and then upload them using FTP to your server. And I actually had to do that with this demo when I was doing that. So that's just something to keep in mind. The theme also only includes 6 months of support when you buy it. And support's really the main thing that a theme offers to make it a premium theme. So that's a little bit of a downside. They do offer some discounts on 1 year. But chances are that if you are really committed to building your website, you can get it done in 6 months and get the support that you need. But that's just something to keep in mind if you want that continual support. Overall, I really like the Avada theme. It can allow you to create so many great looks, and all of it without using code. Figuring out all the settings can be a bit of a hassle. But for the most part, the settings and options are really well designed and really well thought out. So if you'd like to learn more about the Avada theme, check out my free tutorial where I'll show you exactly how I set up the homepage, this page here that I created. And if you'd like to be guided through a complete setup of this theme, check out my Avada theme course. And if you're interested in getting the Avada theme, go ahead and check out the link below this video or at realwebsitehints.com/Avada. And for more reviews, tips, and tricks that will help you build websites more easily, be sure to subscribe to my channel or visit me at realwebsitehints.com. So, if you've got a question or suggestion for a future review, go ahead and leave a comment below. And thanks for watching.